We found that the lift coefficient on a cylinder can be expressed like this. And so let's look at the actual dimensional lift. That is 1/2 rho V infinity squared times C times the non-dimensional lift coefficient. Well, C is just 2R for the cylinder, and the lift coefficient we can substitute in there. So this lift can be written as 1/2 rho V infinity squared 2R times gamma over R V infinity. So the R's cancel out, the 2 cancels out, and the V infinity, one of the V infinities there, cancels out. And so we're left with the sectional lift coefficient is equal to R V infinity times gamma. Well, it turns out that this is true for more than just a circular cylinder. This is true for any two-dimensional object, two-dimensional cross-section. And this was discovered independently by Kutta, who was a German mathematician in 1902. And Joukowski, who was a Russian mathematician, in 1906. So they each discovered this independently and published on it. And so we call this the Kutta-Joukowski theorem. And again, that is that the sectional lift is equal to the density times the free stream velocity times the circulation. Now this is technically only true for incompressible two-dimensional potential flow over any arbitrary two-dimensional cross-section. And this has also been validated through experimental data at high Reynolds numbers. As your Reynolds number increases, the thickness of the boundary layer decreases. And we can see that in the limit, as a Reynolds number gets very large, this equation is in fact true. And so these potential flow solutions are very accurate for high Reynolds number situations and predict the lift to a high degree of accuracy.